Looks like I really got her stuck.
Start the motor, and I'll push you out. You think you can really do that? I can do it.
Thanks. Thank you. That was some kind of strength. I appreciate it.
No thanks needed.
I like hard work.
My name's Bob.
Okanagan.
Okanagan. Where are you from?
Livingston, Texas.
The reservation.
Yeah. Reason why I'm here is I'm looking for a job.
Now, you know, that's funny. I was just saying to my wife this morning that I needed some extra help around here.
Maybe it's my lucky day.
Maybe it is. You know anything about farm work?
Oh, yeah. I can drive a tractor, feed cows, ride horses. I can do anything around here.
Well, you mentioned a few of the things that we do here.
Oh, that's great. You see, I want to move my wife and little ones over here just as soon as I can.
Oh, how many do you have?
I have one wife, 3 kids, 2 boys and a girl.
All right, I'll tell you what. We'll try it on for a few days. If everything works out all right, then you have a permanent job.
Thank you.
All right. Would you undo that log chain? We'll move this tractor up to the barn.
Okay.
Okanagan, this is my wife, Laura.
Glad to meet you, Okanagan. Welcome.
Well, thank you. I'm glad to meet you, ma'am.
Okanagan's going to be working for us. Now, that little house over there, that's your quarters, so go ahead and make yourself comfortable.
Thank you.
See you at dinner.
Okay.
Honey, I think we got a good man there.
Terrific.
Mind if I have some of that?
You got it.
Thank you. You picked yourself up a couple of buddies.
Oh, that's okay. They're real nice. Makes you feel right at home.
Well, that's the way we want you to feel.
What's the supper? Just wait and see. Take your elbows off the table. Do you speak Indian?
Oh, sometimes. But mostly I speak English, just like you.
Oh, not just like her. She doesn't speak very good. Well. Huh? She doesn't speak very well. Oh, that's what I just said. I'm going to give up.
You sit right there and behave yourself. I'll get him.
Who is it, honey?
Teacher and my son, Wally. And the son, Wally.
Well.
Oh, how are you? We didn't want to interrupt you all here.
Oh, don't be silly.
we don't want to disturb your supper.
Have you had your supper?
Oh, yeah.
No.
That's come on.
Yes, you can ride on over here and enjoy it.
Right over here. We were just in the neighborhood, and I was taking my son around, introducing him to everybody. He's new in the ministry, you know.
I'm very happy to meet you.
Yes, welcome.
Excuse me, preacher. This is our new hired hand.
Okanagan.
Pleased to meet you,
smelling food sitting on it.
Oh, son, that's not a proper blessing.
Come on, take it.
Guess what?
Got me.
What? But she says that a real Indian who lives in that place is working for his dad.
Is that so?
Yeah, that's so.
Well, we'll just see about that. I ain't having no dance burn engine moving in around here.
Now, but I don't think you can do anything about that.
The rest of the city's real nice.
There ain't no such thing as a nice engine. If you remember, a few years ago, that old Indian tried to move in here, and we all got together and got that partition up, had him run out of town.
Yeah, I remember. Times have changed.
There ain't no dumbass Indian gonna move in around here.
Mind you, that's what the paper boy said. There's a real Indian over the fence, and he's doing a rain dance. That's no way to drown those children.
Well, we could use the rain.
Yeah.
They was talking about it at the feed store. Said they saw that Indian sending up smoke signals.
Smoke signals?
I'm for talking to the judge and signing up and getting him run out of here.
Me too. I don't understand Bob hiring an Indian.
The Indian leave our area. Now, I'd like to quote a scripture from chapter.
Now, preacher, I just don't have time for this today. I've got dinner cooking on the stove, and I just don't want to bother you. I'm sorry. Goodbye.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. It's right here. And it plainly says that all men are. Hello? Hello, Miss Brown. Lord loves you too, lady.
Morning, Miss Davis.
Well, well, just look who stopped by so early in the morning to see little old me. You know, praying in church just last Sunday this would happen, and sure enough it did. So I had my eyes on you. Come on in, you handsome hunk of a preacher.
Well, you see, Miss Davis, I'm here about the people signing the petition.
Well, you just come on in here, and if you play your cards right, I'll sign most anything you want.
No, Miss Davis, you don't understand. I don't want you to sign.
Well, pretty face. Like I said, you play your cards right and I won't sign nothing. I just love to play cards, don't you? Aw, come on now, come on. Don't the good books say you should love everybody? You finished the dishes, honey?
Yes, ma'am. Sure took you long enough.
Never mind, but tomorrow night's your turn.
You know, ma'am? You're really a good cook. That's the best pork chops I ever tasted.
You just like home cooking, that's all. Anyway, I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Well, you sure earned them. You worked hard enough. You're catching on to ranch life real fast, and that's good.
I'll stay a long time, Okanagan.
Hey, did you know that Okanagan has 3 children of his own?
Really?
Would you mind telling us a little something about yourself?
Well, actually, there's not too much to tell. I grew up on a reservation. But I would like to have a nice place of my own someday. Maybe I'll get a chance.
Well, let's just say that this is the first step.
Well, I think so far you've given me a chance, and I want to say that you've been very nice to me. And I'll bet all the people around here are nice like you.
What's that noise? Stay right there, Laura Bell. I'll check it out. Some of the old timers in town didn't want an Indian living there, so what they did was they got up a petition and they all signed it, including Judge Hawkins. And they ran the Indian fella out of town. It's kind of like they're fighting the Indian wars all over again.
That was a long time ago.
Yes, yes it was. Things are different. Times have changed.
Yeah, things are different. But are the people?
That's a good question.
Yes. Oh, no. Really? Well, send them in.
Yeah, I'll leave it. I'll tell you what, we'll do something, I know that. Right. Well, we'll just talk to him, we'll get straightened out. Judge, you're gonna have to do something about this engine.
That's stinking red.
All right, now just wait a minute. Wait just a minute. Now hold your horses. I can't hear you when you're all talking. Now, Rufus, tell me what the cat hair the problem is.
Now, that burn problem is a bad burn engine out there at the Spence's ranch. Now, here's what we want to do. We want to get us up one of them partitions. Oh. And we want to get everybody to sign it. We want to run him out of town, just like we've done before.
Oh, Rufus, come on. That was a long time ago, and times have changed. People can live where they want. That's the law. Now, I know that I signed that petition along with the rest of you folks before. I'm not proud of it. I'll never do it again. So, Rufus, you might as well forget about that petition. That goes
forget about it? Well, ain't no way we're going to forget about it.
You might as well.
We should have gone along with us on
that. Well, you're going to have to do it on your own.
You just wait
to
see.
I'm book on that.
Now, come on, folks. Let's just get out of here. Let's just see who we vote for next time. Young to be a preacher, man.
That's old Butler's son.
Guess it runs in the family.
Sorry, you're never too young to do barge work. Mr. Pickle, gentlemen.
Well, preacher, what brings you out this way?
You know why I'm here, Mr. Pickle.
Well, you can just forget it. I ain't changing my mind about this petition.
That's just not very Christian.
WB, I wonder if I can get you to sign a petition right here, please, sir. Appreciate that.
That's a good idea.
That's
Excuse me, I don't believe I got your name.
My name is Raymond J. Johnson, Jr.
Well, Mr. Johnson, I...
Doesn't have to call me Johnson. You can call me Ray, or you can call me Jay, or you can call me Johnny, or you can call me Sonny, or you can call me Junie, or you can call me Ray J, or you can call me RJ, or you can call me RJJ, or you can call me RJJ Jr. But you doesn't have to call me Johnson.
Well, I got news for you. You doesn't have to call me Mr. Pickle.
Have you figured out how to cheat at
Dominoes yet? No, but I'm still working on it.
About the Indian?
Preacher, I know all about that petition. There's no way, absolutely no way I'll sign it. Come on, boys, let's go.
Thank you, ma'am.
Say you saw that thing?
Over there.
There's nothing there now. Come on, let's go back to the house.
Look!
It's just old Smokey.
Yeah, maybe old Smokey now, but it wasn't old Smokey a while ago.
All right, okay. Come on, let's go get some sleep.
Thank you.
telling you what you saw last night was old Smokey.
No, I saw it only too good. It almost got me with his big hands and feet. Who's that?
Looks like Truman Langford's car. I wonder what he's in such a hurry about.
Hey, Bob. There ain't nobody worried about the Indian anymore. Man, he ain't nothing. Did you hear what happened last night?
No, what happened last night?
Oh, some crazy creature running around.
Was he a real big, hairy-looking thing?
Yeah, that's it.
Where?
Everywhere. All over the place. He almost turned over Don Bailey's car, tore the window out of Jay's house, jumped on the back of his car as he was trying to get away, and then he tore up Judge Hawkins' office.
I told you, Bob.
Going on around town. I'm spooky.
Yeah. It ain't enough to worry about that engine. Now we got some kind of creature thing running around at night. I just thought I would mention supper.
Supper?
Yeah, supper.
What do you expect for supper, Rufus? You done had me out here all day long working with these horses.
I know. A little bit of good about right now.
You'll be doing good to get bologna sandwiches.
Well, that's what I figured I'd get tonight.
Thank you.
I was telling you about? I found it. It's a real beautiful place. Would you go with me and take a look at it?
Sure, I'd like to see it.
Here's Miss Linda Harness with a Bill Anderson.
Who's that? That's Rufus. Don't worry. He won't bother you.
Hey, Bob. That big hairy monster was over my house last night and wrecked everything. Horses broke out, crowd.
Oh, now, wait a minute, Rufus. Just take it easy. Now, what is it?
Well, it was terrible. It's what it was.
Maybe you should farm manhunt.
Manhunt my foot? You're gonna have to farm us a booger hunt, or a beast hunt, or a monster hunt, some kind of hunt. Engine, you ain't no problem no more. You was for a while, but you ain't no more. Now we got a real problem. A big problem.
Now, Rufus, just don't get in the lather. Go home and relax. Do something at home, but just take it easy. Don't worry about it.
Well, I'm gonna go home because I got a lot of cleaning up to do. There ain't gonna be no relaxing, I can tell you that.
Okanagan, I think our big problem is Rufus. Let's go take a look at that property. Getting back to the ranch. You can stay here and look around if you want to.
By the flow of the inland river, where the feet of men have tread, where the blade of the great grass quivers, asleep are the ranks of the dead.
pretty little valley.
I wonder how much it takes for a down payment.
Well, with what Griffin's asking for it, I'd say around, $2,100.
$2,200?
About that, yeah.
Oh, that's great.
You know, I've been doing some thinking, Okanagan. That big hairy monster thing's been hitting all around us. But it hasn't hit right here. Now that's strange.
Oh, that's not so strange. Look. A tooth from a white panther keeps away evil spirits. Now Bigfoot, they come near the house, but he won't do any damage. Where I live, because it always works.
Matter of fact, say, why don't you and I take a ride over to Rufus's place and see how much damage that big monster did?
Okay.
Thing you should mention that. I was just saying the same thing this morning to Okanagan. Okanagan? Go on. Okay. Sorry.
Tooth from White Panther. Keep away evil spirits. Bigfoot may come near me, but Tooth from White Panther make him go away, not do damage near me.
Beats me, Rufus. So far, so good.
Make me believe that. From a dang white panther, keep that thing away. I'm close to looking dead.
Tooth from white panther, hard to come by.
Yeah, I reckon. Sure wish I had me one of them things. This thing really worked, does it?
So far, so good.
I'll tell you what I'm gonna do, Benjamin. I'm gonna give you 5 horses for that dang thing.
No trade tooth for 5 horses.
Now, I am prepared to make a better offer. Say, 6 horses?
No.
7?
No trade.
Come on, Okanagan, let's go.
9? 10?
Oh, yeah.
too, honey?
Big monster just turned over from a dime. I was living.
You don't mean to tell me you believed in that thing, do you?
About what happened to Dan last night.
What happened? You're out now.
I don't want to talk about it. Me and Okanagan were safe at home.
Say, Engine, what would it take to buy that Panther 2?
You know, have enough wampum to buy Panther 2.
Would you stop at the store and get me a bell pepper and some olive oil? I'm going to cook up a mess of spaghetti for dinner.
Sure. Anything else?
No, that's it.
All right.
Uh-oh, here comes Rufus.
$2,000. $2,100. $2,200.
Yes.
All right.
dog.
Oh, boy. Now me and my tooth gonna show that big old hairy varmint.
Okanagan, this is a good piece of property. I'll talk to Mr. Griffin about it. I think you have enough money for a down payment.
I sure hope so. I want to build a house for my family.
You miss them, don't you?
I sure do.
Tell you what, I'll just help you get that loan. Would you like that?
Oh, sure thing.
Okay. Let's see where you can put a dam down in this creek, huh?
Thank you. monster things are getting out of hand.
Well, Truman
hadn't done anything in a while. Sure. Who else would have done a blame thing like that? Wrecked the judge's office, didn't it? Just have another cup of coffee.
Hey, how you doing, Troy?
Hey, what y'all up to? I guess you heard about the courthouse fire last night.
Oh, yeah, that was too bad.
I heard it on the news. I didn't believe it.
And they just got the loan for remodeling, too.
Won't be no remodeling now. We're going to have a whole new courthouse. That means a lot of money.
Truman thinks it's
big. I'm getting a hunt party together. I've already called everybody I know. We're going to find that thing.
All right, I'll get my gun.
Come on, Reed. You come on in the house with me. The kids will be home from fishing soon. We got a free start, you know.
Quiet, everybody.
Quiet.
I said quiet. Uh-huh.